Good evening. Not many goals to show you, but loads to talk about on tonight's late kickoff. I know Danny Mills, but I'm delighted to welcome the former Sunderland and England fullback Mickey Gray and his old teammate at the Stadium of Light, the Carlisle United skipper Paul Thirlwell. Are you full of pent-up frustration at having trained all last week and then your game at Stevenage gets called off?
Yeah, it was a bit unfortunate having the game, but the manager still had us in training Saturday morning, so there wasn't too much rest.
Oh, I felt sure you'd like take it as an opportunity to sit on your jacksie and eat Maltesers and stuff like that.
It would have been very nice, but we've got tram here tomorrow night, so we had to prepare for that.
Got to keep going. So you were training on Saturday lunchtime. You were at the Stadium of Light for Football Focus. And around the same time, dramatic events at Old Trafford were ensuring that the subject of racism continues to dominate this football season. As well as Suarez and Evra, John Terry is facing a criminal charge that's left England without a captain and now without a manager. Players have been racially abused on social networking sites. And now the Prime Minister, no less, is set to hold a summit on the issue. One of the country's leading anti-racism groups, Show Racism the Red Card, is based on Tyneside. But, as Andrew Hartley reports, the charity is facing an uncertain future just at the time you'd have thought it was needed most.
I've heard you speak quite passionately about the issue of racism in football and in sport in general. In your opinion, is it a better sport, less racist now than it was when you came into it?
I don't know, man. It's a hard one.
Racism in football, resurgent. The domestic game has been left reeling from a string of race-related incidents.
I'll be honest with you, I felt like I've almost kind of been fooled a little bit over the years, because you look back to the days when John Barnes and all the guys were playing beforehand and all the stuff they were
bananas
having to deal with,
bananas
on the pitch, etc. And I've always been someone who's championed our country for making great strides, and we have, but I thought it was that era was gone.
And it's happening here in the north. The former Leicester City striker Trevor Benjamin recently experienced racism firsthand from an opponent whilst playing for the Northern League side Morpeth Town.
I just backed into the goalkeeper and he said, "Oh, you're black so and so and you're black this and black that." It was like, kind of, where did that come from? Do you know what I mean? Angry, upset. Wanting to hurt the person who said it, as well as you've got to kind of control that and not willing to go that far, because that don't solve anything.
Trevor's experience has led him to work for the Tyneside-based campaign group Show Racism the Red Card. It uses football stars to deliver a strong anti-racism message.
Show Racism the Red Card.
The vast bulk of our work is done outside the football stadia and in classrooms. You know, if we talk to young people every day, and racism's still a huge problem. You know, racist attitudes are still very prevalent. Racism's changed quite a bit. You've got the growth of Islamophobia. You know, racist attitudes are still out there, and therefore, you know, there's still a huge need for our campaign.
Today, the charity's working with school children at an event in Sunderland's main council chamber, spreading the word, former players from Newcastle United and Sunderland.
I was manager of Darlington Football Club and I was on my way up, making my way into the boardroom, and I was stopped at the door and questioned and said, "You can't go in there, it's only for managers and directors and chairmen." And I said, "I am the manager." And the shock on that person's face is though to say, "Well, you can't be a manager because you're black."
Among the stars, a former Newcastle defender, now living in the northeast.
Well, racism can happen to anybody. And myself, I didn't know that. You know, there's a lot of things regarding racism that I didn't know. They really opened my eyes. And as soon as I retired, I've been going around schools, educate young people, and you know, it's been really good.
In his early days at Newcastle, Olivier Bernard experienced prejudice in person.
There was a police car just behind me. The policeman came out and asked me to get out the car and start saying, what are you doing here? And obviously he understood that my English wasn't good. Why are you in England? I was petrified.
Despite the slew of recent bad headlines, the group believes that racism is not a problem specifically for football.
Certainly society has a much bigger problem than football currently does. Professional football in this country is, I still think, a beacon. And if you look at the role models we have involved in our campaign, hundreds of current pros involved in the campaign, thousands of players throughout the world, then football does, you know, certainly fight racism in a much stronger way than society has in this historically.
If one of my teammates showed racism and was racist, I'd say something myself, and you know I wouldn't have it myself. I think that's what it's a matter of now. Individuals and the clubs doing a bit more and targeting the big players or the players who are doing it.
At a time when football has been engulfed in racism controversies, Show Racism the Red Card is in jeopardy after revealing losses of more than £90,000 last year.
We're funded by a number of organisations like trade unions and local authorities, and we're seeing cuts within our budgets. So, you know, obviously you can't continue to run a charity on the basis of £96,000 losses. There isn't many organisations like ourselves, and I can't think of any, with the UK remit to combat racism. So if we weren't there, then racism certainly would be on the increase. We're doing a great job. I mean, it's a job that will have to be done for many years to come, unfortunately.
Well, aside from those high-profile national incidents on our patch, as well as Trevor Benjamin's horrendous treatment in the Northern League, Fraser Campbell and both Amiobis have recently been abused on social networking sites. I mean, what on earth, Mickey, is going on with our beloved national game?
Well, it's certainly gone too far, and I think it was all finished with. But we're still seeing it now, we're seeing it on TV, and everybody seems to be talking about when football should be the winner. It really should be. I've been in dressing rooms with black players who are really good friends of mine, and I'm certain Paul's obviously still in dressing rooms at the moment as well with them, and they're great guys. You've just got to, everybody's got to get on together.
I mean, can you remember the last time, Paul, you bore witness to a racist incident in and around football in any form?
Well, my own personal experience, I find that quite shocking. I haven't sort of recently been involved or seen anything other than what I've seen on the telly from my personal experiences in the dressing rooms that I've been in. But obviously from seeing that, I did realise it was a problem, but it's now a massive problem and it's something that needs to be addressed. And more so, I think, for the youngsters watching us in our game, the game that we play, they see us first and foremost as role models. And we certainly need to stamp it out in the circles we're playing in.
Which is what Show Racism the Red Card is all about. I mean, here's the bit that I don't get, right? And I think we all have markers over the years, I certainly do, of racist incidents across the time I've been watching football. And it was brought home to me a couple of years ago. I was down at Blundell Park, Grimsby, and a group of youths, talk about Neanderthal, it was back to the 70s and Love Thy Neighbour and all the rest of it, the way they were abusing a certain player. Stewards dealt with them brilliantly, got them out and all the rest of it. But what I don't get now is the numpty at Anfield with the Tom Adeyemi incident. A single voice shouts out of the crowd at Plymouth for the Southend game the other week. Mm. Where is this coming from? What is the mindset of people that would do that?
Well, have they been brought up the wrong way? And also, you've got to look at it. The fans around the player or the fan who's made out this racism remark in the crowd itself, surely the rest of the fans around him should say to him, well, listen, keep your mouth quiet.
Well, I think, in fairness, at Anfield, that is exactly what happened. And I think the guy at Plymouth has been, you know, pulled out on the same basis.
And another thing as well, I think, obviously, the players do their part. We go on the pitch and you wear the T-shirts, Show Racism the Red Card, which I think is great. But should we still be really doing that now? I mean, that's the big question mark. I mean, that should be finished with now. There should be no racism in our game. And it's a great... I mean, football's a great way of showing your reaction towards it, and you've got to try and cut it out.
Have players and you as captain been briefed by anybody, by the club, by the PFA, as to how to deal with this situation recently?
Well, other than like Mick said, we have the red card situation. Mick will tell you his time. Every team photo you have at the beginning of the season, you have your photo with the youth team, the directors, and then the racism cards come in. So it's straight at you from the pre-season, then it goes right through. At various times, you wear the T-shirts. We're having the T-shirts out into the fans. So you're trying to get the message across all the season through. And it's just a shame that however many people, whether it's a few, a minority or a majority, are starting to let people down, but it needs to stop.
Paul, have you thought about what you might do if you heard an incident within your club and how, as club captain, you might deal with that?
Well, for one, I don't envisage it ever happening. And two, well, you would be disgusted, wouldn't you? We've had black players come and go and all kinds of races coming out of football club, and they've been treated, like Mick says. In the game, we have great black friends.
I think the thing that Paul's saying there, it shouldn't just come from the captain. It should come from the whole squad. If you ever hear anything like that, you just put a stop to it right away, and it should just have no place in any work area, not just a football dressing room.
And with those senior black players coming out and talking about it so strongly, now surely is the time for full zero tolerance and major penalties for anybody that books that trend. We can only really scrape the surface, can't we, on late kick-off of a subject like this. If you'd like to join the debate about racism in football, the Twitter address is at LKONEC. You can find us on Facebook, and the email address is clem@bbc.co.uk. Still to come on tonight's show.